Hello everyone. Well, in this video, I'm going to discuss how to receive the data in a specific format. So let me send the request. Currently, we are getting the data in XML format. That is a default behavior of our application. If I want to receive the data in a specific format, I need to provide that information in the form of headers along with the request. Headers are also in the form of key value pair. So let's say I want to receive the data in JSON format. So the header which I need to specify along with the request is, so the key is accept and the value is application/JSON. Now this header will tell the application that the expected data is in the JSON format. So click on send. Now as you can see here, I'm getting the data in the JSON format. In the same manner, if I want to get the data in XML format, just use the value as application/XML and click on send. So we are getting the data in the XML format. Now same thing you can do with the help of HTTP client. That means if you want to attach the header along with the request, you need to take the help of HTTP client class. Inside this class, there is a property called default request header. Now using this property, I'm going to attach this header to receive the data in a specific format. Okay. So here I'm going to create a test method that is public void test get all endpoint in JSON format. So the steps remain same. Create the client, create the request, execute the request, and then receive the response. After that, close the client. So the attribute which I need to use with this method is the test method. Okay, so HTTP client equal to new HTTP client. Now I need to attach certain header along with this request. So for that, I'm going to use the property that is default request headers. So HTTP client dot default request headers. This property is going to return us the type as HTTP request headers. So request headers. So this class inherits from HTTP headers, and inside the HTTP headers there is a method called add where we need to specify the key and value for the header. So I will use request headers dot add. The key is accept and the value is application slash this on. Okay, now the rest of this step remains same, that is create and execute the request, fetch the response content from the response, and close the HTTP client. So this will be your get URL. Okay, so just let me run this test alone. So if you look at the output, you can see here we are getting the data in the form of JSON. Similarly, if you want to receive the data in XML format, let me just create a duplicate of this method. The header will be slash XML. And this will be XML format, and run this method alone. So if you look at the output, now you are getting data in the XML format. Okay, so this is how you specify the header along with the request. And there is one more way by which you can specify the header. So as you can see here, we are using the header of type accept. If I go inside this class, there is already a property called accept which will be used to create the similar header. So just let me create one more copy of this method. Using accept header. So now instead of add, I will use request headers dot accept. Okay, which correspond to the same key dot add. And as you can see here, it will accept the type as media type with quality header value. So I'm going to create the new instance of media type quality header value. Or let me make it JSON header. And specify the header value over here. And now you can just remove this line and specify this object directly here. So this is the different way. Although the output remains same. So if you look at inside the HTTP request header, they have categorized the different types of header and they have created the property for them. And we are using this particular property for the accept. And let me run this. Okay, so if I look at the output. Okay, so this is the output and it is in the JSON format. So that's all for this video, and thanks for watching.